Mike. Yes, carry on, brother.
Hello, good evening. My name is Sivam. I'm from Malaysia. I'm actually been all over the world to do the best to get the most peaceful mind for all over the brothers. Okay, I have a company in Malaysia which have all the people working with me, including Africans, Pakistanis, Bangladesh, Thailand, and a few other countries. What I find here, I would like to talk, I will be very pleased to, and thanks to you all to give me opportunity as a last talk. I was following up these for many, around 8 years, you know. So why am I disappointed here now? When you talk about the peace, it should not come from only the word. It should be come from the activities. Okay? The major things going on in the world is not in the way of peace. You must understand the most peaceful language is come from love. What is going on in the Middle East now? It's politics. I just now don't want to voice out because the politician is here. I don't want to see any politician because the politician, the world become crashed. Okay? I want to soon in anger because in why, you know? So my question here is very, very clear. You cannot deny it. If you do the good thing and the best thing, even I giving the best thing to my staff, is from all over the world. I'm taking them as my own family. Then when I die, he said, I didn't carry the good things. I don't go to the correct place. Who went to the heaven and come back and tell that I never been the whole place?
Brother, what's your question?
Brother,
this is a question answer time.
Yeah.
What is your question? You already given
a question. Is very clear. Yes, I was looking into the question all people putting on you. I'm very clear. It's all a basic question. I'm asking the floor. 80% or 90% of you, don't you understand what you say? You all should know very well. It's written in Quran. Everybody should know. You what you are explaining now, just now, it's all a basic, which I know. I have a lot of brothers working with me from all. My question is, you cannot deny a person, if it is, I respect other religions, Hindu, you know, Amadam Sambandam, you know what is the meaning of that? We respect other religions. I'm a vegetarian. I don't eat fish, I don't eat chicken, I don't eat anything. Okay? I got 3 children, I even touched my hand with my wife, you know. Just now you told me Hindu can marry more wife. I ever, never, never, even my wife die, I die. It's something like that.
Brother has asked a question. Brother, I've understood your question. You have given a short speech.
Yeah.
This is a question answer time. You're talking about practice and you're breaking the rules.
You give me a clear answer. If you are a non-Muslim, if they do a lot of good things, you want to pay for the masjid or what, I've done everything for church and all. You are telling me that I don't get the correct message to go to the correct place?
Brother asked the question that if a non-Muslim gives charity, etc., and he said that, will you go to the correct place? Your question is everything garbled. You have to ask simple question. You have given short speeches that you should not read book. You should practice Middle East. You have family. You said so many words, but there was no clear-cut question. A question should have a question mark in the ending.
What I'm trying to say, very simple. Can you give me the answer? If non-Muslim, good things, even give our life to Muslim, we didn't do the best for you all. Even when I die, many people say it's very pity if you're not Muslim. Is this correct answer?
Brother is asking that if a non-Muslim does good things like he has given charity, so when he dies, will he go to heaven or hell? That's what I understand. Brother, the answer I already gave earlier. When you sit for an examination, like when I sat for my 10th standard ICSC, there were 6 subjects I had to pass. Science, English, Hindi, History, Geography, I had to pass. If I get 100 out of 100 in 5 subjects and 1 subject, science, I get 10 out of 100, will I pass? I will fail. So similarly, the criteria to go to Jannah, to go to paradise, is you should have faith, number one, righteous deeds, exhort people to truth, exhort people to patience and perseverance. You may be a righteous person, you may be giving charity, etc. But if you don't have faith, if you don't believe in the one true God, if you don't worship the true God, you fail the test. So for you to pass, you have to pass in all the 4 criteria. Iman, that is have faith, believe in one true God, should not do idol worship, should not believe in false gods. Number 2, righteous deed. Number 3, exhorting people to truth, that is dawah. Number 4, exhorting people to patience and perseverance. So you, if you do not believe in the one true God, and do not worship him alone, associate partners with him. Under no circumstances in the next life will you pass, you will fail. Hope that answers.